sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. The fairy tale is complete. The Central Coast Mariners, champions of Australia.
Good afternoon and welcome to Amy Park on the land of the Wurundjeri people. You are watching live on Ten Bold and Paramount Plus Sunday afternoon football in the A-League, where defending premiers and grand finalists for the last 4 years, Melbourne City are looking to confirm their climb away from the foot of the table under the stewardship of new coach Aurelio Vidmar. They're taking on a MacArthur side who are defying the pre-season predictions so far, undefeated in their opening three games. It's the Bulls, not City, that can go clear at the top of the table with a win at Amy Park this afternoon. Mind you, that will mean that the Bulls have done something they have never managed to do in their three previous A-League seasons, and that is win against Melbourne City. Seven times these two sides have met. Five wins for Melbourne City and just two draws, all MacArthur have to show. And that head-to-head record is even worse here at Amy Park. Three consecutive defeats, including 6-1 last season. But there's something different about this Bulls side this season. We'll see if their current good form continues. A win for Melbourne City will relegate talks of a crisis to the history books, or at least the shelves for a moment, but Aurelio Vidmar's upward trajectory experienced a little turbulence in midweek. A loss to Buriram United by a goal to nil in the Asian Champions League. But back-to-back wins in the A-League for them will see them climb onto the cusp of the top six. Vidmar has made two changes from the side that lost at home then to Buriram United. Jamie Young continues in goal, but despite a first clean sheet of the A-League season against Sydney last time out, Samuel Suprayan and Scott Galloway return at the expense of Curtis Good and Callum Talbot. Elsewhere in midfield is unchanged, and up front, Leo Natel, the Brazilian, makes his first A-League start after three appearances off the bench alongside Marin Jakolic and A-League's all-time leading scorer, Jamie McLaren. MacArthur are also involved in continental action this season, and in midweek Jonathan Aspro-Potamides and Yanni Nicolaou were both rested. They return this afternoon after that 5-0 home win over Phnom Penh in midweek. Kieran Backus, the former Melbourne City player, also returns in the middle of the park for Jake Holman. No changes in attack, where former Melbourne City player Raphael and Jed Drew will operate wide with Frenchman Valère Germain through the middle. He's got 5 goals in 7 appearances since arriving from Montpellier in the off-season. Kickoff is coming up. Well, we've got a couple of ex-Socceroos at the helm. There is Mile Sturzowski in charge of MacArthur Bulls, and enjoying a good start to the season, Mile, the former Northbridge Bulls youth coach, and a player that went and got Valère Germain from his French contacts. He used to play in France. Aurelio Vidmar played most of his overseas career in Belgium, and a spell in the Netherlands, also a spell with Tenerife, 44 caps. He coached Adelaide 73 times in the A-League, but that was before Melbourne City even existed, let alone MacArthur Bulls, back from 2007 to 2010. Got his first goal in City Blue, Stephen Ugarkovic, last time out, an important goal as well. Ben Abraham is our referee. It's the first time he's taken charge of this fixture between Melbourne City and MacArthur. He's being assisted by Kearney Robinson and Peter Jaworski. Chris Griffith-Jones is in the VAR room. Top spot is on offer, Andy Harper, but not for the three-time defending premiers, Melbourne City, but rather a MacArthur side who'll be looking to take their excellency start to the season to the next level with a first-ever win over Melbourne City.
Afternoon, Robbie. Yeah, it's these early matches in the season where teams have put together a couple of weeks of some sort of form where you learn a lot about that mentality. And Melbourne City, a troubled start to the competition. They bounce back with a win for the first game of Aurelio Vidmar. Well, that's too early to tell if they've turned a corner. More importantly today is to see if MacArthur believe they're the real thing. Top spot's waiting for them. Can they go get it? And will they learn from the experience in maybe achieving that?
Lovely little jink and an early chance for McLaren. It was Yakulish feeding Arslan. And the little turn to find half a yard of space in the box and then feed McLaren, already less than a minute in, seeing all the class of Tolgay Arslan.
So the ball's nearly put back on the hill. It's a wonderful little shift there from Steve Ugarkovic. The danger man on the end of it, Jaden McLaren.
Karen Backus doing the marking on Arslan at the near post. Delivery in is a good ball, the head up from Supriyan. And now the break is on for the Bulls. Backus feeding it wide to the former City man, Raphael. Chance to run at Bajic. Now who's that come off last? As is Bajic wants a goal kick and the referee concurs.
I thought Backus went the wrong way there actually. He had two options. Raphael on the left and Jed Drew, who in a foot race has probably got Raphael by half a nose, but he just looked to me to have a more direct line to goal. Jed Drew out on the right hand side. Backus had his time again, he might have redone that one. There's a good breakaway from MacArthur, and for their part it was a good recovery from Melbourne City.
Ugarkovic striding forward, finding Yakulish. His pass is loose though, picked off by Backus. Gilau with Raphael. Winning the throw. There is Marin Yakulic. Wears the number 44 shirt in honour of the former Croatian basketballer Drazen Petrovic, one of the great Europeans to go and play in the NBA. And his dad was actually his football coach back in Šibenik in Croatia when they were youngsters. Here is Davila on the charge. It's a good ball wide for Drew. The early cross back in, dealt with by Nuno Reis.
Yeah, didn't get hold of the cross at all, Drew, unfortunately. How good to see Uli Davila back in the swing of A-League action. He's one of the comp's big draw cards, at least from my vantage point. And to see him pivot and cut a swathe through an opposing midfield is just really exciting. He put the ball on for Drew and he couldn't match that effort, Jed Drew.
As in comes the corner, and it's dealt with by Scott Galloway, making his first start of the A-League season after three appearances off the bench. Samuel Supriyan, the Frenchman in the centre of defence, makes his second start, but the first since that 6-0 defeat at the hands of Adelaide. Header. It was a powerful one from Nicolò. Referee judging that he led with the elbow. Yanni Nicolaou, one of a couple of players, Andy Harper, we've seen this weekend, who won the NPL New South Wales with RB Leichhardt last season and getting his chance in the top flight. Marconi youngster. There's Natel. Good ball for Yakulish into the area. Yakulish takes the early shot, trying to go through the legs of Nicolau. As is Bajic, has it back with Ugarkovic. Mahic again. Forced all the way back with Supram. Here's Arslan. Scored City's first goal of the season on a otherwise difficult afternoon against Western United. They lost their first two of the campaign, conceding 8 goals, Melbourne City, but they bounced back with a first clean sheet of the campaign last weekend. They're sitting equal top of their section in the Champions League as well, just behind Ventforé Kofu, the Japanese side. On goal scored, Arslan with a little ball for the Frenchman, French-Moroccan, Hamza Saki. Now the cross in to McLaren. Oh, it looked like he hardly jumped there, McLaren, as the ball was heading straight onto his head. Ugarkovic does well. McLaren again finds the space to feed Jakulish. He comes back inside. Shot blocked. Desperate defending Rafael. Now Bajic across the face and beyond everyone. And Hamza Saki won't want to see that too many times again. A great chance to get his first A-League goal. I love that midfield trio. Arslan and Ugarkovic have both scored, along with Jamie McLaren for City this season. Hamza Saki will be eager to get his name on the score sheet as well. Leo Natel, his header, only finds Jed Drew, who is lightning quick. Galloway's gone with him, matched him stride for stride. Nuraish. Arslan again, fantastic control and turn, getting the better of Vujica. Nikolaou's header away, Ugarkovic is there, here's Jakulish again. But Natel at the back post, McLaren in the middle. The ball is for Natel. Arslan. Well, he's already bringing some oohs and ahs from the crowd. Tolgay Arslan, he's that kind of player. And really arriving in the A-League at the peak of his powers. In towards McLaren, Bushcock. Oh, Backus, that's dangerous. A little overconfident, perhaps. McLaren saying he didn't touch it, should be a corner. Referee agrees after a word in the ear, perhaps from his assistant, and a first corner of the contest.
Well, there's the ball back from Backus. And Curto caught on his heels as well. Short-term reprieve for MacArthur.
First corner for City. It is as Bajic hits it. Always moving away, but it's taken a touch on the way through, and it's going to be another corner.
A sharp start, the opening little period for Melbourne City. They're looking really up for it. It's a rare sight. This is Bajic shooting. It took the faintest of deflections as well on the way through. No question about the corner, but the shot was never on target off the boot anyway.
Referee Ben Abraham coming to have a word to Tolgay Arslan. Backus and Germain wanting to have words with Tolgay Arslan as well as the referee. Just a little bit of push and shove. In comes the ball. Plenty of pace on it. Curto can only sort of palm it down. It was neither a punch nor a catch. Arslan finding Jakulish again. Here's Saki. One of the set-piece takers. Jakulish has done that nicely. Squares it. The chance now for Leo Natel. Oh! The thought that was going to squeeze inside that bottom left-hand corner.
Good side at goal. Lovely swivel there from Jakulic. Nice control, unconvincing finish. But as is a lot of the things with Melbourne City's football, and certainly today, it's the initial prompting of Arslan which opens up the field. It gets the juices of the teammates going. And it's a little sole of the foot here or a dummy there, and everyone gets excited. Luckily for Jakulic, he was the next to receive the ball. He put his little bit on it as well. That'll be a foul. It's a good combination, this, from Melbourne City. Already made the mistake of mistaking Stevie Ugarkovic for Arslan. They cut very similar figures from a little bit of distance. To this point, the creative spark is coming from Tolgate, and he's outstanding. And what a matchup we've got. Davila in black and white, Tolgay Arslan in sky blue. Both players worth the price of admission.
And great to see a couple of real number 10s in action as well. The old debate of whether the number 10 still exists in modern football. I think we've got a couple here. There's another little touch from Davila. Over the top from Rafael. He had Jed Drew wide. Supraya back to Jamie Young, and the situation could have been far more dangerous. He's diffused. If you look at this Melbourne City side today, there's only one player that was part of the finals campaign last season, Jamie McLaren, the captain and goal scorer. Scott Galloway was on the bench at the back end of last season, but in the starting 11 at least, Nuno Reis as well. It's otherwise all change, and starting is Andy Harper set to gel. Jakulic has been an ever-present since joining as well on the left wing. For the first time in the A-League, Alessandro Lopane is not starting a match, with Leo Natel, the Brazilian, on loan from Corinthians. Sao Paulo youth product. As we heard in the pre-game show, a player has never played in the first division in Brazil. Six seasons consecutive loans away from Corinthians, but they keep him on contract, so there's something there. Four shots to nil at the moment in favour of the home side, who have made a confident start here. If we've learned anything in the first three matches of this season, it's that MacArthur, Hullo Wellington Phoenix can be a tough nut to crack. Jakulic taking on Nicolau, no way through.
For Yanni Nicolau, he started very strongly. He's making a fist of this opportunity. And he's outfoxed Jakulic there. He had him. And it's a reward for Melbourne City that they hadn't really earned. Not in that dual situation anyway. That was the defender's game. Now, probably just a little bit of a rush of blood. A bit more composure. He could still be carrying the ball upfield.
Hamza Saki, ball back post. John McLaren, who thought there was a teammate there, in the end has his badge, will keep it in play against Vuitsa. Bacchus and Vuitsa managed to get it clear, but only as far as Nuno Reis. Now Galloway. Galloway again, able to turn. Natel, early cross. Can't pick out McLaren. Now sliding in, yellow card for Leo Natel, who claims that he got the ball before barreling into Rafael.
It's a clear yellow card. He had any intention to collect the player or do anything nasty, but he was just late. His desperation to get the ball, putting in that no-win situation. Clear yellow card.
Oh, getting a little word, probably in Portuguese, from Rafael on his way past. Rafael, the son of Adelaide's Brazilian Cristiano. As we're seeing a lot of the next generation of A-League player now. As the league grows, as it matures, the youngsters are coming through. He got his first goal for MacArthur when he opened the scoring against Brisbane on the opening day of the season. Here's Backus. Mentioned that MacArthur are also in continental action. They're in the AFC Cup. They were big 5-0 winners over Phnom Penh of Cambodia in midweek. Davila was on the score sheet. Rafael as well. Xiaomao from the penalty spot. Uzcock and Lockie Rose off the bench. So sharing the scoring around. And they have a chance here. Jed Drew with the corner. Just chipping the ball in towards Jamie Young, who got there just over the top of Uli Davila. The lowest save percentage in the league after three matches so far this season, Jamie Young. We're talking about the Jamie Young, goalkeeper of the year when Western United won the league two seasons ago. Last season again with Western United, a saver and denier of spectacular goals. But it's been tough so far, and most of the pain came from that 6-0 loss to Adelaide as Jakulich was putting Nicolau under a lot of pressure. That's a battle to keep an eye on between those two. Here's Rafael again, cutting inside. Thought he was fouled by Jakulich. Referee doesn't agree. Bajic finding Natel, able to turn. Now Galloway down the right-hand side. Turns inside Vujica and outside. Galloway! In the end, it was neither a stinging shot or a clinical cross that Curto could claim.
It's a good rate forward from Galloway. Field open nicely for Melbourne City. Patel putting Galloway through. There was a moment there where Vujica might have been able to intercept the pass, but he was caught in that decision-making no-man's land. As it turned out, it was Galloway who then got the upper hand.
See there, the match for the moment being played in mostly in MacArthur's defensive third. Melbourne City on the front foot, but Vujica looking towards Xiaomao. We haven't seen too much of in the opening 18 minutes so far, the Frenchman. Arslan able to turn and run with the ball. Feeds Jakulich. This has been one of the flashpoints so far. Natel with Ugarkovic. Jakulich again, this time crosses deep. He's looking for pace. Vujica finds Jed Drew. Udaspro Podomides. And now Clayton Lewis. MacArthur playing their way out of a tight spot. Xiaomao almost stealing the ball away there. Switch of play. Now Vujica has played at that. It was going out. He tried to control it. They were thinking Natel was offside. Gone, and while Melbourne City still have the initiative, MacArthur have just put the brakes on those nervy moments at the back. Saki. Raish and Supreon. Supreon. possession. Melbourne City, it's the hallmark of their game. Patience. Try and move your opponents around. Haslam with Bajic. Supreon looks over the top for Ugarkovic. Finding space on the left wing. His cross turned behind by Nicolau.
Well, the consistent attacking all being done by Melbourne City, and Nicolau just getting dragged in to midfield. Jakulic with left the flank open. A little bit of correction required there. Some communication to be polished up across that back line. Jonathan Aspro-Potamidis, the nearest centre-half, needs to just be that little bit tighter.
And it comes near post. It's Germain's header away. Aspro-Potamidis as well. And it's Germain that clears it long, only as far as Galloway. With Hamza Saki on loan from Auxerre in the French second division. Jakulic on loan from Angers, also in the French second division. Here's Aspro-Potamidis. It's up with Clayton Lewis. This from Jonathan Aspro-Potamidis. Fantastic run. Finding Davila. Early ball, looking to release the pace of Jed Drew. Now can he pick out a cross? He does so with Davila. Not an easy one to control at pace, and they have to be careful here because here goes Arslan. McLaren. Arslan being buffeted about. No free kick, says the referee. Backus really sticking to his task there. Now they're going to Germain, has put it out of play so that Arslan could receive a little treatment here. The referee coming across. Let's go down to Michael Zapponi on the sidelines, Abbas.
Yeah, this is an interesting one because Arslan's been playing with a broken toe on that foot where he's just trying to take his boot off. So he might have copped a knock on that. He looks like he's in a lot of pain. Let's hope he's able to resume. But yeah, he's been carrying that for the last few weeks. It doesn't look great for Melbourne City with one of their stars in a lot of pain at the moment. Cool conditions here today, despite the sun shining, only 17 degrees. A few interested parties looking on as well. The Socceroos staff are here, and so is Tony Popovich, Melbourne Victory coach. Melbourne Victory have got their next game after the international break. They face MacArthur away. So Tony Popovich keeping a close eye on things. And there is Graham Arnold, of course, who'll be keeping a very close eye on two of his stars who have been named in the Socceroos squad, in Jamie McLaren and Aziz Bajic. They come into camp. There's Matthew Leckie as well, who is currently injured. But Andy Harper, aren't we loving Robbie Thompson today and the French pronunciations? There's a bit of a French feel about today, and they just roll off the tongue.
Uh-huh.
Oui.
That was my next one. Yeah, let's hope. But he's not crook, but he's limping, favouring heavily that injured foot.
Merci, Zappers. There we have Arslan, who was rested for that match against Adelaide, that famous 6-0, because of the broken toe.
No sign, Zappers, of a substitution. Civil play?
Not at this stage. Now, it looks like he's going to try and continue. Having said that, I'm just noticing one of the assistants going over to a fourth official, so it looks like they might be preparing for a sub. I'll try and find out very soon.
Oh, yeah, keep us a bridge of what's going on there. It doesn't look good for Tolga Arslan, who's just had a word to Aurelio Vidmar and is not heading back towards the halfway line to come back on.
Yeah, Terry Antonis about to come on.
Well, that is a big blow for Melbourne City and a blow for the neutrals as well, who we've enjoyed just in 25 minutes seeing a clearly not 100% fit Tolgoi Arslan pull the strings in midfield. But Terry Antonis, an opportunity for him, a new lease of life for him at Melbourne City as well, after the disappointment of last season and not a single minute of A-League football at Western Sydney. Here's Aspro Potamides with Bacchus again. For the moment, City down to 10. Davila, he was looking for Jed Drew. Galloway and Reish very watchful. Clayton Lewis has done well here. Can he take a shot? Does so! And Jamie McLaren with a fingertip save.
I think McLaren, Jamie Young has done brilliantly here. I think he's misjudged initially the pace of the shot. Look, he almost has to take a moment to try and hang that bit longer. It's a fantastic save in the end. Clayton Lewis has really tested him.
Confirmation of that substitution as Terry Antonis into the game in the 27th minute. Jed Drew with the corner. Well, that was a bit of a confused set-piece move.
Well, they've wasted all their set-pieces so far. McArthur have been a very poor part of their game. Haven't had a lot of looks. But the two or three they've had have been misdirected, under-hit. Very poor.
Clayton Lewis has never beaten Melbourne City. It's the only A-League team during his time with Wellington Phoenix that he never managed to beat. He almost got a rare goal there. Has one assist already this season. International, number 23, receiving from Nicolau. Supraiong's header finds Jakolic. Now Hamza Saki. Ugarkovic. Melbourne City with nearly 55% possession of the contest so far. 6 shots to just 1. That effort from Clayton Lewis, the first for the visitors. Now I mentioned the record at the top of the program. 3 games here at Amy Park. 12 goals conceded, just 2 scored for 3 consecutive defeats. The best they've ever done is 2 1-1 draws against Melbourne City. Antonis with Bajic. Early cross. Who's Cock?
If you were just to make one point of comparison between McArthur and Melbourne City so far, is when they get the chance, City's delivery into the box is just way more threatening. And that was a reasonably straightforward interception from Tommy Uzcock, but he needed to be sharp and in the right position because the ball was going to find that part of the ground. It's just not been the case so far for McArthur on the few opportunities they've had.
Saki delivers again. Again, it's too close to Philip Curto. He's looking to release quickly. Does so now. And again, he's down that left-hand side with Jonathan Aspropotamides. I wonder if that wasn't something they've worked on. Then that's the second time we've seen Aspro charging upfield, receiving the ball from the keeper. Vujica, whose only ever A-League goal came against Melbourne City back when he was at Western United. Oh, Supraiyan almost offered that up to Davila. He's disappointed with himself because it's a corner and a needless one.
You also get the feeling that there's real potential between Davila and Jamar. MacArthur don't have an out-and-out striker playing, though, and it almost looks like they need that for both of those in pitcher to find each other's game. And just missing that point of the attack so far. Now, obviously, Mile Sojoski has set the team out with the intent of not having an out-and-out number nine, but it does look like it's hurting them a little bit at the moment.
Well, both these sides have found goals hard to come by so far this season. Backus crosses in. Suprayan's header away. Uzcock. Just three goals scored from Melbourne City so far this season. Only four for MacArthur as Davila, who got a header in midweek against Phnom Penh, almost got his head on that. Saki. A little 1-2 with McLaren. That's well read by Lewis.
Well, that was much better service from Jed Drew, putting Melbourne under some pressure.
Clayton Lewis again with Backus. Now was Cock. Zappa's mentioned the Socceroos, as is Bajic and Jamie McLaren recalled for the Socceroos matches against Bangladesh on Thursday in this very stadium. Free kick goes MacArthur's way, a foul on Davila. We've also got a few Oliroos just called up. Jake Holman, who's on the bench, and Raphael for MacArthur. Callum Talbot, who's also on the bench for the first time this season, also called up for the Oliroos.
They arrived very late there, Suprayan. Straight through the back of Davila. Not worthy of a yellow card, but I thought it might have been worthy of just a little chat from ref to player. Just cool your heels on those ones.
Clayton Lewis. Set piece taker for MacArthur. He plays it short with Drew, wide. The cross in towards Jamal. Here's Backus. Down by Ugarkovic. Terry Antonis trying to lead the high press. Jakulic as well. He's lightning quick, Marin Jakulic. Who arrived in Australia with the passport after his dad played here. And grew up here till the age of 15. And perhaps with one eye on impressing enough and Graham Arnold's watching on. Maybe not immediately for the Socceroos, but there is Graham Arnold just casting the rule over a couple of his charges for those two matches coming up. A good turn and ball over the top for McLaren. Curto will get there. Jamie McLaren. He's often been the thorn in MacArthur's side. Six goals in six for Jamie McLaren against MacArthur. Raphael, no way past Galloway. Looking for McLaren again. Terry Antonis is there. Clayton Lewis. Closed down and just fouled. Only just.
Not sure. On Jamie McLaren, that one. Clayton Lewis played himself into trouble with a heavy touch. I think he got out of jail there. The Kiwi International.
Now MacArthur. Just over 10 minutes to go in the first half. Yet to concede a first half goal in the A-League this season. MacArthur, the only side, yet to trail for a second of football. Three rounds in. And one over the top for Germain. He he gets there with Drew. The cross in for Davila. Nice touch as well, taking him around Suprayan. Just couldn't stay on his feet as he wrestled to bring the ball under control. Bajic back with Ugarkovic, and another little moment for City at the back where they have to be careful. Lecky, as we saw, sitting in the crowd. No Andrew Naboot, who's coming back from that Achilles injury. Natel, the cross. Jakulic can't reach it. After a bright start, we haven't seen too much of Leo Natel in the last 10 or 15 minutes or so. It's also coincided with MacArthur getting stronger and stronger. Galloway comes inside. Suprayon takes over. Oh, pretty even. That's different. Where Andy Harper said there's a real clinicalness and accuracy to the crossing and those final balls in. What can Jed Drew produce here? German coming short again. The cross doesn't beat the first man.
But this is partly Jed Drew's issue, but he was looking up and looking up, and without someone actually holding the line with the centre halves from a black and white perspective, he can't hit that early ball. Look how far off the line German is. He's looking to hit that centre forward and it just doesn't exist. By the time the run has made it to the box, Melbourne City have cut off the pass. Now, Jed Drew needs to be a little bit more inventive to recycle that. His last 10 or 15 minutes have been really encouraging from Jed Drew's viewpoint. He's certainly a dangerous problem for Melbourne City, but he's got to find that final solution.
Lewis's ball in, the punch from Jamie Young. Saki.
The game, Robbie, way more within MacArthur's reach without Tolga Aslan. Melbourne City have lost all their spark without him. Let's see if they can find something here now.
Big switch from Antonis for Jakulic. The overlapping run opens a bit of space for Marin Jakulic. Shot blocked. Reish for Bajic, it's a great run. They're in behind them here, as is Bajic. One way, then the other. Blocked again, the follow-up. Natel can't bring it under control. Too many black and white shirts in the penalty area. Well, that was a great run. Dribbling in and out from as is Bajic. Here's Jakulic, but Bajic may have hurt himself here. Now Jakulic, the cross in. Again, just that deep ball to the back post, but overhit.
There's a beautiful switch from Nuno Reish to Aziz Bajic. And I guess until, I hate to say it, Aziz scores from one of these raids down the inside left channel of the penalty box, we're going to keep referring to the Argentina round of 16 match when he just did so bravely and so brilliantly and couldn't find that goal.
I bit my tongue.
I know. Well, Simon Hill couldn't help himself last week. He drew the reference, and you've refrained from now. I haven't. But let's hope you can soldier on. It's just a little knock for him. And he's a very dangerous player, as is Bajic, and just has built such a fantastic career for himself.
Oh, Clayton Lewis gave it away cheaply, and the idea was right. The execution was not. Nice touch from Hamza Saki. Antonis wide for Natel. It's a heavy touch. And it's comfortably dispossessed by Ivan Vujica. Aspropodamides long towards Germain. He was known more in France, as I think we've seen in the A-League, Valère Germain, not as that out-and-out striker, as you rightly say, but as an intelligent second striker, one that can move off the ball, can find those little pockets of space, can bring other players into the game. And I think we've seen his positional sense already at MacArthur, but it's not brute force, it's not power, it's not back to goal, and it's not sheer pace either.
Certainly not that. He's got plenty of football in him, so too Darwin. I think they're a great pair. It's that third piece that's missing.
Well, Lockie Rose moment. Is on the bench, as here's Natel. It's a good first time ball this time. Galloway with Antonis. The cross towards McLaren. Uzcock only as far as Hamza. Well, he has knocked out Tommy Uzcock on the penalty spot. With a thunderous volley, Hamza Saki thought he was wheeling away in celebration there.
Well, hit it nicely. Tony Antonis ignored him in the first instance, but off the header of Tommy Uzcock, and it goes back at real velocity from whence it came. So Tommy's okay.
Well, I'd like to see it again. It did hit him in the side of the head, I think.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. There's no doubt. No question. Heads the ball clear here. Right on the jaw.
Right on the jaw, yeah, absolutely. They've probably been doing a bit of boxing pre-season.
Well, let's hope not, Robbie. What are you suggesting?
Oh, just a cardio.
Oh, shadow boxing.
I do have to check him. Tommy Uzcock has to leave the field of play. So, defending a man down. And again, Jakulic goes deep, but that's a great header back. Reyes a second time as well, but can't beat Kurto. Ooh, and Reyes has had words there with Clayton Lewis. And you could see the reaction of Clayton Lewis. Absolutely furious about something that I think looked like something that was said more than done.
No, I think he's complaining about what he perceives as Nuno Reyes lashing out. Beautiful ball to the back post. Got it magnificently in the first instance, Nuno Reyes. Comes again the second time, and as he goes down, we don't quite see there, but Clayton Lewis makes it very clear as he, shall we say, runs with intent.
That he's been stepped on or something a second time.
That's
perhaps
his perception.
Wants to have a word. Uli Davila as captain coming across. Now VAR having a look. Well, let's have a look. Here comes the second header now when they go to ground.
There's that little, he thinks there's that little second action from Nuno Reis. I don't know if quite knows what's going on, but he's prepared to stand his ground, and he's probably feeling a little heated by the exchange as well. I'm not doubting for a second that Clayton Lewis thought something untoward had gone on. He's not the type to react like that. He's not looking for a stink, but he certainly had fire in his eyes.
Well, not enough.
And it didn't look like it to us either.
Absolutely, drop ball. Penalty is, of course, a very stern sanction with the opportunity probably 7 or 8 times out of 10 to certainly score a goal. So you need to be absolutely sure, especially when we know that goals can be hard to come by against MacArthur. Aurelio Vidmar watching from the sideline. He's already been forced into one change, losing his star playmaker. Was the throw was taken quickly by Melbourne City, but it was actually a throw from MacArthur. MacArthur, who won their last game very, very late on against Western United. It was an 84th minute winner in the end from Backus against the Mariners before that. They are hard to break down. And he has a bit of firepower on the bench, Mile Stojovski, as well. The likes of Lockie Rose, Ali Ugla as well, who's got his first goal in that win last week against Western United. Stoppage time minimum to be played at the end of the first half. Nattel. Galloway has to work hard to bring that back down with Nunaresh. This is Bates. You can see at the bottom of your screen has recovered from that knock on the knee. As he continues to motor up and down. The left flank has certainly been performing at a higher intensity than the right flank for City. Yakulish was everywhere early. Now Germain. The pass. Oh, as Yakulish pounces. He's so quick, forcing Uzkop to work very hard. Now Yakulish has crossed. Aspropotamides heads away. Yakulish again finds Natel. Back out to Garkovic. Another great block, and Yakulish following up. Out, well out for a goal kick, but more desperate defending.
Well, the best of MacArthur's defending on show in these latter periods. Uzkov and Aspropotamides, an unheralded duo, but I just think together they've been fantastic since they've been a partnership at MacArthur. Okay, so Tommy was outstripped for pace then by Yakovlev, but he got back enough to join forces with Aspropotamides, who then threw himself in front of that shot to see things away.
Drew can't keep it in play. It's been a struggle for Germain so far in this match. Outnumbered, outmuscled up front for MacArthur, and Uli Davila alongside him. You see there defending in a 4-4-2 formation has also struggled to have a consistent influence, I guess, on proceedings so far. Aspropotamides turn to hand it over to Hamza Saki. Antonis, one way then the other. The cross in is deflected. Has it been kept in play? No. But it's out, and the referee's assistant has given a goal kick now, which I think... Well, City can't quite believe it. It looked deflected off the boot of Terry Antonis. That's why Curto tried desperately to keep it in.
Doubt it was deflected. Sometimes you do just scratch your head. Ben Abraham's terrific ref. He's had a good game again today, but these little moments come up and you just think, how did that get through? Anyway, it did.
Well, the 4 minutes of stoppage time are up. No more to be added on. A difficult first half for both sides. City, who lost a little of their swagger when Tolga Arslan came off, succumbing to that suspected broken toe that he's been nursing for a couple of weeks. We haven't seen too many flashes of brilliance from Valer Germain and Uli Davila at the other end. MacArthur have built their success this season on steely defence, and it's the case again here at Amy Park at half-time. Scoreless between Melbourne City and the Bulls. And let's head off to a quick break before Tara Rushton returns with all the half-time show.
year's Alex Tobin medal is brought to you by Isuzu Ute, awarded to the best player of the season as nominated by the Paramount ANZ football team. The winner of the prestigious award will receive $10,000. Plus, the Isuzu Ute Alex Tobin medalist will nominate a junior football club of choice to win a brand new top-of-the-range Isuzu D-Max or 7-seat MUX to be announced during the grand final. To stay in touch with the leaderboard, tune in for weekly updates at your home of football.
Welcome back. Aurelio Vidmar looking to make it 2 from 2 in the A-League for Melbourne City since he took over. And MacArthur looking to extend their unbeaten run in the competition. All tied up at halftime, 0-0 here. Here is the Paramount Plus Player Index. Nuno Raish on top of it for Melbourne City with 74.3. Aziz Baic, I thought, has been outstanding in that first half. A lot of the dangerous stuff from Melbourne City has been coming down that left-hand side. Aziz Baic making positive runs and even getting close to scoring in that first half for Melbourne City as well. Scott Galloway coming into the side today on the opposite side, right-hand side, also scoring well, 72 in the Paramount Player Index. Don't go away. Kick off for the second half a moment away.
In the sheds with Aurelio Vidmar there. Just some final words as our two teams begin to return to the field of play. MacArthur making their way back out onto the playing field here at Amy Park. MacArthur FC, who for the fourth time in four matches this season are 0-0 at the break. All the action with the Bulls comes late so far this season. So let's hope for their sake that's again the case, because in that first half they offered precious little going forward, just the one effort at goal from Clayton Lewis, well saved by Jamie Young in the City goal. Our two sides are back on the field of play. Nuno Reis was very accomplished in that first half, a tidy first half at the back for City. Jakulic and Saki started very brightly with Tolgay Arslan. Jamie McLaren hasn't seen too much of the ball, but he's that constant threat in the penalty box, of course, and he scored more than any other player in the history of the league, full stop. 145 goals in 209 appearances today, but also 6-6 against MacArthur. As is Bage back in Australia after a decade on the road in Turkey, most recently in Scotland as well. MacArthur, in this their fourth A-League season, they've only ever been top of the table for four weekends. Three weekends 2 years ago, never after the fifth round of the season. If they can get a goal here, they will move top of the table after four rounds. But Melbourne City, certainly the more adventurous side in the first half, Andy Harper, as this second period gets underway. Surely there are goals in this.
You'd think so. You'd think so. I mean, Melbourne City need to find themselves Sands, Tolgay, Arslan, of course. And if they can even come close to filling that hole, they'll be favourites to run out with this one, because they have had more enterprise in their play. But you know, MacArthur are set up well. They're very, very determined. 1-11 across the field. That's a big part of football. You know, you can cover a lot of gaps, perceived gaps, real gaps, by individual application, and then you knit that together. That's MacArthur under Milos Teodosic have done very well, and they're a tough unit to break down.
Well, let's head straight down to the sidelines to hear what was said in the shed. Zappers is with Scott Jamieson.
Well, Scott, Aurelio Vidmar said before the game that you needed to be a bit more clinical in the final third. Is that something you spoke about again at halftime?
Yeah, it was. It was probably just playing into the big centre-half's hands a little bit too much. Them eating up things. So we've tried to spread the message to the players to try a few different things with that.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Great stuff. Zappers getting the word out of the changing rooms at halftime. Certainly they've had the better chances, they've had more chances, but of their 11 shots at goal, just two on target for the defending premiers. Here's Natel, the Brazilian, who gives it away. It's picked off by Rafael, called up to the Oli Roux squad to take on Saudi Arabia and Qatar in 2 weeks' time. Socceroos will be in action before then, and don't forget, for the first time ever, we've got the Unite round coming up in January, from the 12th to the 14th of January. It's an extra full round of matches, so we're going to have 27 rounds this season. It's replacing round 12, which will be played midweek, calendars permitting, but 3 days in Sydney, 12 matches, A-League men and women all involved. So make sure you're a part of it. Tickets for that go on sale tomorrow, Monday. And if you're a club member, you've already been given the option to get your tickets at a discounted price as well. But the Unite round certainly one to look out for as Sydney get their big football festival. As here goes Raphael, looking to use his pace straight through the middle. As is Bates, wasn't having any of it. And then he's caught by Valère Germain. A little nip at the ankle. No complaints from the Frenchman. Numeresh. That's a good challenge from Clayton Lewis. Davila, oh, he was looking for Raphael. Now Jed Drew, the cutback towards Davila, but again, not enough numbers in the box.
Of all players for MacArthur, I thought that was a dead cert from Davila to find a black and white target. He couldn't. Raphael was free.
Clayton Lewis, the run in behind from Germain, first time effort. And the first sighting on goal for the Frenchman in this contest, saved comfortably in the end by Jamie Young, but it's MacArthur putting the pressure on here. Bacchus driving the ball in, but again they just can't find their targets in the middle.
With time too, and he's had a good season, Bacchus. A terrific, fine player. And that was the money time. In a fantastic situation, and he could have picked out a player of his own team. Instead he finds the goalkeeper. Away come Melbourne City.
He got his first MacArthur goal against dynamic Herb Cebu in the AFC Cup. He then got his first A-League goal as that cross slices off the top of the boot and behind, the first A-League goal against the Mariners that made it 2-0 at the time but turned out to be the winner after Brian Kaltak got a late consolation goal. First game in charge, the 2-0 win over Sydney. Aurelio Vidmar has seen his side dominate but unable to make it count, and Young called upon again to deal with another cross. Saki waiting for Leo Natel. Now the overlapping run from Galloway back inside. Antonis. Saki for McLaren. Galloway, the ball. Saki had made his way into the middle. Neat build-up from City.
Very good. And again, just expert central defending from Asmar Podomedes. Covered that first post. Brilliant. Look at Asmar Podomedes now. Just recovering the ground, sensing the trouble. No fuss whatsoever. Just get yourself into position and see the ball away.
For City, Hamza Saki. And it comes near post. Valère Germain with the defensive header. Saki again, straight back in. It was Nicolau with the near post header. Ugarkovic, pass Raphael. Ugarkovic straightens up. Ugarkovic hits it. Not worrying Philip Curto.
Well, tempted was Ugarkovic after his recent goal. From a bit closer, but a similar circumstance. He does need to shoot more. He can pack a punch. It's just a confidence thing, I think, for Steve Ugarkovic. Player more used to starting much deeper in the build-up and therefore not getting those shooting opportunities. But when they do present themselves, I think he should be more forthcoming and accepting the opportunity.
14 goals before today for Steven Ugarkovic in the A-League. As Drew gets down to the byline, cleared behind, Ugarkovic in his 198th A-League match turns it behind.
It's not that far wide. His second or third touch didn't help him either. It was a little bit lateral rather than a bit more direct. Still, he made a good effort towards goal. Such a fine player, Steve Ugarkovic.
Jed Drew. Again with the corner. Young. Only Davila. Just lurking behind, waiting for the moment. And asking the question of referee Ben Abraham, how long does he have to get rid of the ball, the goalkeeper? Nuno Reis, good ball into the feet of Natel. His little touch found Galloway. Saki for Antonis. The switch now for Jakulic against Nicolau. Jakulic. Bacchus coming across to help out. Saki still, Antonis outside with Bajic. Drives the cross in, Curto punches, poked goalwards again by Antonis. And the MacArthur goal survives again.
Probably the nearest we've come to a goal, Robert. Nice play again from City. And a delivery into the danger zone of real menace from Aziz Bajic. Curto scrambling, so too Lewis. And anywhere will do from Ivan Vujic's viewpoint.
Long. Supriel and Nuno Reis have the measure of Belial Germain so far in that contest. Hasn't been easy for the MacArthur front two, who look to hit on the counter-attack but so often wide with Raphael and Jed Drew. Here's Clayton Lewis. Of the contact, like he was being completely coat-hangered there by Ugarkovic. Teammates at Wellington Phoenix last season. Germain looking at the first-time ball for Raphael. Bajic. Comfortable. Good header from Aspro Podomides. Davila and Nuno Reis tangling, and that's a loose ball forward again for Leon Natel. Davila's touch, Clayton Lewis looking for Jed Drew. It's a well-weighted ball in the end. Jed Drew gets there, but they've gone out of play off the boot. Or is it offside? Offside flag up against Jed Drew. Mile Sturzowski, the very mild-mannered Mile Sturzowski, not one to raise his voice, just observing from the sideline. Champion as well, Sturzowski with the Mariners as Natel. That's a great run. Leo Natel with the chance to finish. Turned Vujica inside out. And then when he needed to provide the finishing touch, couldn't do so.
Well, second great chance of the game. Remember the shot first half from the edge of the box? And on this occasion, he snakes his way quite cleverly into a very, very good shooting position and pulls the shot wide.
It's another very good chance for Melbourne City, though, who will be kicking themselves if they don't pick up the 3 points on what we've seen in 58 minutes so far. Antonis, his pass was intended for Galloway. Natel gets there, little flick for Ugarkovic, who rides the challenge of Bacchus. Outside with Galloway now. Galloway crosses, McLaren is there. And the man with the 100% record against MacArthur makes it 7-7. with his second of the season. And finally, the Bulls' resistance is broken.
Well, on the Harvey Norman replay, we've seen that without Tolga Arslan, Melbourne City have missed a spark. But in the last couple of minutes, in these last couple of attacks, it's been Leo Patel who's found the little touches around the body, outside of the right foot, etc., etc. And it looked like, as it was going to fall to Scott Galloway, that he should have shot, but it didn't quite settle for him. It was an unconvincing pass towards the centre of the goal from that point on, and you don't need anything more than that sort of invitation for J-Mac to do the business.
Well, you can see what it meant to Jamie McLaren, his second of the season, but also Scott Galloway, his first start of the season, providing the assist, and the fans behind the goal there as well. They enjoyed that one. MacArthur, for the first time this season, are behind on the scoreboard. And so this, in some respects, this term is uncharted territory. How will they react, and are they going to miss out on the chance of heading top of the table? 2 years ago, they went five games undefeated at the start of the season. MacArthur. Substitution coming now, and it will be Leo Natel who makes way. Alessandro Lopani, the former Western Sydney Wanderer, comes into the game. That was the only change from last week's attacking quartet anyway from the A-League. Lopani stepping out.
Well, it's not to say that Leo Natel set the world on fire, but his contribution in the last 10 minutes was really important for Melbourne City, because he was offering that little break in play, clever little contributions around the place. He had a shot on goal himself on the back of one such move that enabled Melbourne City to finally prise the door open. I think Gauntlet has been thrown down to MacArthur. Let's see what they've got. They haven't shown a lot in front of goal tonight. This afternoon, they're going to have to find something pretty soon.
Raphael, the little ball for Davila, and they have. Pretty soon indeed. Less than 60 seconds.
How's that for soon?
And Uli Davila finally getting the opening and showing all his class, the Mexican, with his first of the season. And the Bulls are back on level terms.
Well, onside. Harvey Norman replay. Beautiful from Raphael. Just threaded. Delight for his skipper. And he is such a great player. Composure and technique. Right when it mattered. To dink the ball over Jamie Young and level the scores. Only just gone behind. And the skipper sees to it that they get level promptly.
Well, it was Scott Galloway that was keeping not only Uli Davila, but it looked like the entire Bulls front line onside as that ball was flicked through. Clever little pass. Well, they hadn't trailed before today. They still haven't trailed for long this season. Under 3 minutes behind on the scoreboard for this Bulls side, who are showing, as they have done this season with a couple of late goals as well, that they don't lack character. Sturzhovsky's side, Jakolic, who started so brightly, but we're seeing less and less of the number 44 down that left-hand side. He's earned a corner for his side here. Matt Smith in the background there, alongside Mile Sturzhovsky, one of the assistant coaches, the former Brisbane Roar skipper. Oh, Lugarkovic slipping. Davila against Galloway, looking for support. Raphael on the charge. It's a great reverse pass for Jed Drew. Now Galloway is very quick as well, and Drew just can't find a way through. Plenty of light blue shirts back as well, and the free kick goes against Dávila.
Well, it's a super recovery from Galloway. It would have been interesting to see if Jedrew had stayed onside. But with Dávila resurgent, anything's possible for the team in which he plays.
It's the old cliche, isn't it? They always concede, or most likely to concede, immediately after scoring, and no matter the experience of your side, still it keeps happening in football. Antonis's cross is not a bad one. Uzcock with the defensive header. The City have to do it all over again. Jakulic is trying to scythe his way through. Nicolau with the yellow card for just tugging him back. And one for Raphael for a little too much chat.
Well, there's this is Bajic through. Maybe Raphael wasn't aware at the time that it was Nicolau who was the main culprit. Nevertheless, his frustration overtook him.
Confirmation of those two yellow cards and a free kick. 20 minutes into the second half. This game just about to burst into life, you feel. Hamza Saki near post, McLaren was there. Jedrew is turned away, intercepted by Ugarkovic, who's done brilliantly. Backus manages to clear it long. Dávila under pressure from Galloway's going to throw in. Foul on Raphael.
Well, that's at least the third time. Cyprian has just very ungraciously barreled into the back of someone. Almost a case for repetitive infringements there to draw a yellow card.
A little space here for Vujica. His cross is not a bad one towards Germain and Dávila. It was well defended. Well, there's nice shape on the cross from Vujica as Jakulic looking to release Bajic. Potamides made himself into a little bit of a tight spot there, and we've got a head clash. Lopane and Drew. Two young bucks, they both seem okay.
Well, and Abraham straight onto it. He's really growing as a ref. He started from a high base. He's been great from the start, but just growing in stature, in my opinion. He's terrific. His communication with the players is always clear. He keeps up with the game. His decision-making, by and large, is really excellent.
It's Hamza Saki. Let's fly from distance. Clayton Lewis absolutely furious, saying, are you going to kick the ball back and start again from the back? And Lopane took it quickly, found Saki immediately.
It's a good hit. It's seen a lot from Hamza Saki. I think there's expectation for more, and he's shown in bits and pieces that more can be expected. Quite a consistent article yet.
Clayton Lewis with Backus intercepting. Here's Raphael. Can he hurt his former club? Dávila with Jedrew. Cuts back. Oh, can't find Dávila with the cutback. That's disappointing again. So many times from promising wide positions. And now Lopane, the City, look to come forward. Hamza Saki. Inside out, Antonis. They're overloading this right-hand side. Galloway looks up, crosses towards McLaren. Oh, Nicolau's touch was not the best. Aspropotamides and Bacchus finally help Ivan Vujica get it clear. Substitution is coming. A double change for the visitors. We're going to see the fullback, Matt Miller, come into the game. 5 goals last season, but only one appearance off the bench against Brisbane on the opening day. He's also played the last 2 AFC Cup matches, including in midweek. Matt Miller, so he's on, and so is Ali Ugla, the player that got the winner late show last weekend against Western United.
So just going to be straight swaps positionally, even though we've become more accustomed to Matt Miller as an overlapping fullback. He's going to start at left wing for Jed Drew. Ugla goes on to the right wing for Raphael. Good day out for Raphael. Another important contribution from him.
Sturzowski actually used Miller as that attacking wing option last season, didn't he, when he started finding the back of the net regularly. Nicolau, who's holding down that right back position, at least in the A-League, rested in the AFC Cup in midweek.
And doing very, very well. I'd be half tempted when you look at the MacArthur squad as it lines up currently. I'd be tempted to have him play as centre forward. We've got Lockie Rose as well, cooling his heels on the bench. Would be a great addition. But Matt Miller off the leash against 2 centre halves would cause havoc, potentially at least.
Supreon back outside with Jakolic. Now Bejic. Jakulic again, drives it in low. Ooh. Clearance from Clayton Lewis that time. Could have gone anywhere. Marvila fouled, and it's a yellow card for Saki.
Well, year on year, it's not Miloš Ninković, it's Uli Davila, the most fouled players in the competition, and it's steadily racking up again.
MacArthur with numbers in City's half of the field. Wide with Miller. Good challenge, Galloway. Wanted the throw. It goes MacArthur's way. Bacchus. Well, it's his touch showed too much of that to Lopane, but he got away with it. And here's Davila, looking to orchestrate something, the little ball over the top for Miller.
He's got good energy. A couple of minutes has been on, Matt Miller. What I am liking about MacArthur's attack is that all roads lead to Davila. No one's looking, unless there's something really obvious, to do anything other than give the ball to the maestro. And we'll play off him. And that can be a really good thing for a team, Robbie, with really clearly defined roles and boundaries. Players like Davila, without even having to be stipulated, you just know, let's give him the ball. We'll work off you. You paint the picture. You see what you see.
Change coming in midfield for MacArthur now, with Jake Holman replacing Kieran Bacchus. That too will be a straight swap in the middle of the park. Holman, who started the 3 A-League matches before today. Yeah. 21 years of age, as in the second half, MacArthur have done more in front of goal, even if the shots situation does not reflect it. The quality of the chances have been MacArthur's, including that lovely finish from Uli Davila for the equalising goal less than 3 minutes after falling behind. Now Saki Lopane under pressure from Vujica. Oh, great control again. Davila, is the flag going to go up against Miller? Play on for the moment. The square ball. Ali Ugla, one way, then the other. Oh, and he's dragged his shot wide. Flag up for offside anyway. And the referee is going to take it from where Miller was in an offside position. Over 15 minutes to go. Which of these two sides is going to have the energy, is going to have the desire to carve out another opening to get the crucial goal? Galloway with Ugarkovic. Behic again. Working it around, working it down the flanks, then back. Ugarkovic still. They're staying left, City, as they have for much of this contest. Saki with Jakulic. It's a good run from Suprayan. Something surprising. Step over from Jakulic. And now Antonis. Doing the defending. Saki's touch for Bajic is clever. Goes MacArthur's way to an incredulous, as is Bajic.
We looked and sounded very surprised as the Frenchman strode forward. Potentially awkward situation for MacArthur.
Player that takes the responsibility to make something happen, like Suprayan tried to do there. Create something different. MacArthur, for the most part, dealing with the threat of Melbourne City, or at least keeping it around the edge of that 18-yard box. They've put up a perimeter.
They're well put together. You know, this is a good team that's been put together by Milos Teodosic, but they're lacking that punch forward. Got the goal equaliser pretty much as soon as they conceded, and they've had some very good moments since, and the person who's done it for them is Davila. Jamar is not really contributing, and for the amount that he is actually in attack providing, Milos Teodosic must be tempted to throw on another set of legs, a Lockie Rose or something that can break the line.
McLaren, the shot on the turn, blocked by Asparopodomidis. Still it's there, Uzcock. And Ugla manage to clear their lines, only as far as Nunaresh. Galloway, McLaren wants it early, it doesn't come. Lopane. They do stay organised, they do stay disciplined. Vujica, a great example of that. Davila getting body in front. And drawing the foul off Antonis. To watch Willy Darvili had a couple of injuries. What was a very difficult year. Last season, of course, with the personal tragedy of losing his wife. And finding solace in football. Willy Darvili, and in the support of the club, it must be said, and his teammates as well. Lopani, nice little touch for Ugarkovic. Intercepted by Vujica. He's had a good second half, Ivan Vujica. In a defensive capacity is Antonis with Galloway. Ugarkovic straightens up, Jamal doing the defensive duties, and free kick against Ugarkovic, not allowed to play the ball on the ground.
Well, it was a good recovery this from Jamal.
McLaren running the channel. Wants to get it back from Antonis. He does well, creates space. Ugarkovic, oh, it's bounced off Miller. And easy for Curto. Immediately looks for Uli Davila. Now Lewis for the fresh legs of Matt Miller. Down the left-hand side, he straightens up. Inside, it's a good run. Davila might yet get there. Gets the better of Supriyan. He's been caught on the way down there, Davila as well. Nuno Reis trying to get him back to his feet. There's a little bit of urgency about City as well. They don't want another stoppage. They want the win. Jamal just too easily dealt with there by Samuel Supriyan. Antonis. Galloway. Ugarkovic, again they get numbers into these wide positions, trying to work the channels, create the openings. They know they have a deadly finisher in Jamie McLaren in the middle. If they can pick him out with a good ball, he only needs half a chance, as he showed in opening the scoring. There's a more hopeful ball forward. Second phase, they can't bring down either. Holman with Vujica. Strong foot there from Supriyan. Jakolic. Bajic. Good challenge, Holman. Misaki. Nakolish again, overlapping runs, well played, Saki. Oh, shoots near post. There wasn't a high percentage of success on that one.
No, with that sort of incursion, you'd expect something more promising. McArthur's defence was pretty prime then, as City exploited that opportunity down the left-hand side with a pretty routine overlap. And once in behind, Saki really had nothing to offer.
Davila with those silky touches, finding space on the left. Miller back for Davila. Uli Davila shoots, great save, Young. The follow-up off the post and in from Jake Holman. And McArthur, having been outplayed and on the back foot, conceding the opening goal, have now, with 7.5 minutes left to play, taking the lead and stunned Melbourne City.
Well, on the Harvey Norman replay, by design or accident, it's the perfect concoction. for a team that's got Uli Dávila in it. All roads lead to the Mexican, and he'll find a way through. Well, he forced a save. He didn't score directly. The pitchers tell that story. And it was the enterprise and the technique of Jake Holman to finish this chance. He nails the effort. MacArthur 2-1 up away from home. What a victory this will be if they can hang on. And Dávila is the man. Scored the equaliser, and his enterprise and his leadership has created the opportunity for MacArthur to take the lead.
What a moment for Jake Holman. Just his second A-League goal after scoring against Western Sydney two seasons ago. It brings about a change in the Melbourne City ranks with youngster Max Caputo coming on to replace Hamza Saki. It's an attacking move. Callum Talbot has also come on for his 50th appearance in the A-League. Ugarkovic. Caputo with Talbot, who's replaced Scott Galloway at right back. Caputo's header, not a bad one, towards McLaren. Lopane is there. Flag is up for offside on this near side. And it's another late goal. Their third after the 80th minute mark this season. And that's only in the A-League. They've also scored late in the Australia Cup run, in which they made their way past Perth in the playoff matches before Campbelltown City upset them. And all of a sudden, MacArthur and the 3 points, if they can hang on, that they will glean here, will be heading 2 points clear at the top of the standings after four matches played.
And after the bounce that City got under Aurelio Vidmar against Sydney, which in the short history since has proven that Sydney were very, very bad that day, compare that with what they dished up last night in Adelaide. Great start for Aurelio, and then brought back to the pack. Unless they can turn this around. Disappointment in the continental competition during the week, and trailing at home. MacArthur sitting pretty at the top as things stand.
And there it is. MacArthur, as I mentioned, did also have 10 points two seasons ago after four matches. They ended up missing out on the finals that year in seventh place, having made finals in their first year. And they actually lost 2-0 to a certain Melbourne City. Kolakowski and Tilio, the goal scorers.
Well, then they won the Australia Cup next time through. And last season's league campaign just collapsed horribly.
And there is the Paramount Plus Player Index. And for the moment, a match winner. Who could argue with that? Jake Holman leading the way.
Clearly man of the match.
A match winner. I said, not man of
the match. No, I'm not having a go at you, Robbie. It was a great strike by the youngster. There's more goals than him too.
And it's not just the goal stat that goes into that player index either. Certainly, can't deny he's had a big impact. Jake Holman, that goal will count for a lot. Dávila, he has been brilliant. Through the legs of Talbot, finding Miller, it's brilliant play. Miller for the final touch. Superb football. MacArthur with the dagger into the heart of Melbourne City. And it was the work of Uli Dávila. Yet again, magical football. And then to see the pass at the end of it, Miller kept his cool. Brilliant stuff.
Well, This is just the latest in an incredible highlights reel. The guy's a genius on the Harvey Norman replay. He's a genius, Uli Davila. That's a clever finish too from Matt Miller off the bench. But he holds off Suprayan, just rolls him with the hips. Suprayan even loses balance through the legs of Callum Talbot. He's not even looking. He just knows where the pass is. And then Miller, with great aplomb, finishes that to make it 3-1. But dead set, Uli Davila is a genius. If you don't like watching him play, you don't like football.
Yeah. Fans of MacArthur FC certainly like watching him play. Outstanding. And Matt Miller, who scored 5 last season, he's had to cool his boots on the sideline for long periods of this campaign. Gets a chance against the defending premiers and is immediately onto the score sheet again. And Andy Harper, if I told you that after 4 matches, Melbourne City would have conceded 11 goals at the start of the season, you wouldn't have believed me.
No. They've got a lot of work to do. They're very busy in their transfer market off-season. They've been heavily hit by the absence of Tolga Arslan. There's no doubt about that.
There's the ball in. Supriano. Oh, McLaren has got his second. And perhaps there's still time. Supriano rising in the box with the header. McLaren there to get the crucial touch. 3-2, game on again.
Well, on the Harvey Norman replay, signs of life from Melbourne City. And the real strong point all game for MacArthur has been their aerial defending around the 6-yard box, but it just goes absent with that lead, completely and utterly. At the death here. And Suprayan, who was just rolled and left for dead for MacArthur's third goal, has sought retribution and thrown his team a lifeline.
147 A-League goals. That's now 8 in 7 matches against MacArthur. 5 second-half goals here at Amy Park. And plenty of time left for a couple more. Max Caputo with the big switch of play, looking for Jakolic, dealt with by Nicolau. Now Bajic. Jakolic again. Well, last season, you would have thought City had every chance of not only equalising, possibly even still nabbing a win. That's what their fans are on the edge of their seats feeling now. This season, on what we've seen so far, they could just as easily concede one at the other end. Bajic, Lopane rides the first challenge, goes down, penalty! Alessandro Lopane, and Jonathan Aspropotamides knows it as well as he holds his head in his hands. 92nd minute, and what drama to close this one out.
That's terrific from Lopane. Gets through Clayton Lewis. It's a clear penalty. I mean, it's so clear it's almost worth 2. And it's unfortunate for Aspropotamides. He and Uzcock have been sensational today, but MacArthur have put the cue in the rack at 3-1. They must have thought, not even front of mind, but in their soul, they've done it. Well, they left Suprayan free, hopelessly free, to concede the second goal. And now it's up to Philip Curto to make sure that the lead doesn't extinguish completely. Rousing stuff from Melbourne City. Congratulations to them. And it's Terry Antonis who looks to step up and get things back square.
Terry Antonis, who hasn't scored a penalty in the A-League since 2017 with Brisbane Roar, and he does so here. 3-3. What a moment for him. It's been a long, dark tunnel for Terry Antonis. He emerges at Amy Park with an equalising goal in the 93rd minute. And Andy Harper, we've still got time for one more.
The way things are going on the Harvey Norman replay, the It's a clear penalty. Very, very well put away too from Terry Antonis. 3-3. Still time. And they got a full head of steam, Melbourne City. It's been an incredible escape act. Can they maximise the points? Two to play, plus whatever else the referee wants to add on.
Terry Antonis' last goal, as Jamie Young claims that, came in March 2022 against MacArthur for Western Sydney. It was a consolation goal that day. It might prove to be so much more this afternoon. Bajic, in this incredible start to the A-League season where anything can, and more importantly, does happen. Jakulic with Lopane. The header from Caputo. He did well to find the space in that penalty box. Claimed by Curto.
Well, at 2-1, we wondered if MacArthur could hang on. At 3-1, it seems as though they thought they were home and host. But someone forgot to tell Melbourne City. Easy come, easy go, if you miss Tojoski. Enjoy the view from the summit for probably 2 minutes. And now it's all hands to the pump to make sure they leave with something. Unless Davila can work some magic again. They just got to hang on here, MacArthur.
They have never beaten Melbourne City. They won't get much closer than they did today. Can it happen? Or will Jakulic make them pay even more? They want a corner again. It doesn't go. Nicolau is sitting fine with the goal kick. He's not going to agree with Marin Jakulic. Philip Curto just wants to settle things down a moment. We've had the 5 minutes of stoppage time. Come on, ref, give us another couple just to see what can happen. Curto goes long. We have had two goals in added time, so there should be a minute or two added on. I'm not sure there will be. Whistle in the mouth. Well, what a pulsating, breathless finish at Amy Park. Uli Davila and the masterclass from the Mexican looked like he'd conjured a first ever win for MacArthur FC against Melbourne City. But an opportunist Jamie McLaren and an ice cold Terry Antonis from the penalty spot mean that it's finished a remarkably entertaining 3-3 at Amy Park between Melbourne City and MacArthur. In the end, a draw that will probably suit the away side better on their travels. But what a brilliant second half of football. It's finished here, 3-3. Well, so often in a football match, you feel like a side can be home and hosed. Surely MacArthur will be ruining those final 2 minutes. Let's head down to the sidelines with just a moment's time. Michael Zapponi's running around trying to find an interview for us, and I think he's ready for us now, Zappers.
Absolutely, but Jake Holman here. Jake, we thought you might have scored the winner 2-1 up, and a bit of drama after that. What went wrong in those last few minutes? Did you just switch off, do you think?
For the second goal off a set piece, I didn't think we set up quick enough for that, and they caught us off guard. So that was probably a mental collapse. Their last goal, I think it was just good football. However, we shouldn't be letting them get in the errors to get penalties that late in the game.
At 3-1, we thought you'd had the 3 points. You'd never beaten Melbourne City here, but still a lot to take from this performance today.
Yeah, there's a point to take from that, but we feel like there's two dropped there, especially 3-1 up with 10 minutes to go. It's super disappointing. Cannot be taking 3 points home.
We've been marvelling at Davila for seasons now, but again, he showed us why today that he's one of the best in the league. What's it like playing alongside him?
He's great. He's great. We play in very similar positions, so being able to learn off him every day is unbelievable. But first and foremost, he's an unbelievable person, and that's got better.
He is indeed. You're still undefeated, so well done on a great start to the season.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right, Jamie McLaren's about to join us now. A brace today for Jamie McLaren. It's 2 weeks on the trot now. Jamie on the